From Cebu City, the easiest and most convenient way to get to Bohol is via Fastcraft going to Tagbilaran City. You can buy your tickets just outside Pier 1 in Cebu City. The waiting area is air-conditioned with plenty of seats and snacks available. The journey takes around 2 hours, so sit back and enjoy the ride. The Fastcraft is spacious, equipped with air conditioning and restroom on board, providing you that comfortable ride going to your destination. After a smooth ride, you'll arrive in Tagbilaran Port in Bohol. From here, you'll be ready to explore the unique beauty of Bohol Island.
Nandito tayo ngayon sa Daot Terminal, which is located sa harap lang ng Island City Mall. You can ride a bus here at the Daot Terminal going anywhere in the island of Bohol.
Welcome to the Daot Terminal, Bohol's main transportation hub located in Tagbilaran City. This is where travelers usually start their journey across the island. Whether you're heading to the beaches, the chocolate hills, or exploring local towns. From Tagbilaran City, we took a 3-hour ride going to our first destination in Candiay Town. Ask the driver to disembark you off in front of this market. From here, hire a habal-habal stationed on this waiting shed. From the main highway, head west onto this interior road going to Barangay Kadapdapan. The journey towards Candiay's interior could take up to 30 minutes, passing through the ticketing office and through this steep, narrow road going to the waterfalls.
Ang first na pwede nating puntahan dito sa Anda Candiay area ay ang Kanamantad Waterfalls.
Number one for our things to see and do. Track your way to Kanamantad Waterfalls. The Kanamantad Waterfalls is the tallest waterfall in Bohol, measuring up to 60 meters in height.
Ano masasabi mo sa Waterfalls Bay? Kadapdapan, Candiay, Bohol. And we are here in Kanamantad Waterfall. May mga part dito na very slippery, with highly advisable to get a guide. Tapos nyo yung magtampi sa o maligo sa pools nila, pwede po kayong mag-picnic dito. Free lang po. Pero kung wala kayong dalang pagkain, pwede naman tayong pumunta dito sa Eleuterio Restaurant. So ito yung menu nila, guys.
Number 2. See the rice terraces of Kadapdapan. Who would have guessed that the famous Banawi Rice Terraces has a smaller version located here in Bohol? The Kadapdapan Rice Terraces is located just above Kanamantad Waterfalls. The majestic terraces is located inside and is managed by Eleuterio Farms.
Malayo pa ang pangarap natin makapunta sa Cordillera. Dito muna tayo sa Kadapdapan Rice Terraces. Nandito po tayo ngayon sa Municipality of Anda, which is located in the southeastern side of Bohol Island. Anda is more of like a peninsula. Ito po yung munisipyo nila. Tapos, ito yung basketball court sa harapan ng kanilang munisipyo. Just a few meters away, nandito yung church ng Anda. At saka may malaking open space dito for park and leisure. So, plus factor pa, guys. If punta kayo doon sa area noon, makikita mo na yung beach ng Anda. Another place to visit here in Anda is their main public beach, Kinali Beach. Kinali Beach is one of the largest beach here in Bohol. It is also one of the well-known beach. Kinali Beach offers a big white sand beach for the whole family to enjoy. They also have fine white sand in the beach.
Let's uncover another things to see and do on the other side of Bohol Island. The name Hinagdanan means laddered, referring to the steps leading down to this underground magical world. This limestone cave features a natural skylight, illuminating its bigger-than-life stalactites and stalagmite.
Hinagdanan Cave. For entrance fee only, that's gonna be 50 pesos. Kung gusto mo maligo, 125 pesos. Yun yung mga butas sa ceiling. It would give natural light sa cave. Pero napaka-humid dito sa loob. Mga naglalaki ang stalactites dito sa loob ng kuweba. Ito po yung butas labasan. So, kung makita ninyo, yan yung inaan natin kanina. Ito yung butas pabalik sa taas. And it's time for us to go out of the cave. Ito yung Hinagdanan Cave.
Another thing to see and do, visit historical churches. Bohol is also rich in history and architectural beauty. Scattered around the island are several Spanish-era churches. These ancient churches are not just places for worship, but also symbols for Bohol's cultural heritage and historical colonial past.
Nandito po tayo sa Municipality of Panglao at ito po yung simbahan nila. Nasa likod ko po ngayon ang tore or watchtower ng Panglao Church. Panglao Church is one of the two main church dito sa Panglao Island. Beside Panglao Church is yung nasa Dawis Church. So ito po yung St. Augustine Church or Panglao Church. Panglao Watchtower. Panglao Island is known for two famous beaches. Number one is Alona Beach, while the other one is here. This is Dumaluan Beach. Now, if ang pakay mo sa trip mo is nightlife ambience, at saka disco, fun activity sa beach, yan si Alona Beach kasi napakadaming mga bars at resto bars at saka hotels at saka disco club meron sa Alona Beach area. Now, dito naman sa Dumaluan Beach, kung pakay mo is ang opposite, which is to enjoy a serene, relaxing, laid-back ambience, Dumaluan Beach is the best for you. The Coconuts of Bohol Beach Club. May public beach cottages po tayo dito. At saka, napakalawak na beach area. At saka, bonus factor pa guys, sa Dumaluan Beach at saka sa Alona Beach, given na talaga, fine white sand. As in, super fine white sand.
Speaking of fine white sand, hindi magpapatalo si Alona Beach.
Alona Beach is quite different compared to Dumaluan Beach. For Dumaluan Beach, which is very laid-back ambience as well as Kinali Beach, this area right here is more upbeat.
Every morning, Alona Beach transforms from a night hub where activity, fun, and leisure is to a tropical paradise.
This is Alona Beach by the day. Turtle! We'll be right back.
Let's hop over to Anda for our ultimate stopover.
So, kung gusto nyong maka-experience ng mystical side ng Bohol, ito po yung Malamanok Island. Considered as the cradle of civilization here in the island province of Bohol, what you can see here in Lamanok Island are 6 different caverns. Each cavern has its own unique story to tell pertaining to the pre-colonial era of Bohol. About 10 to 15 minutes walking sa bamboo boardwalk. We can already see from here the Lamanok Island.
From this wooden dock, we ride a traditional bangka going to the island. The boat ride could take up to 15 to 20 minutes, enough time for the boatman to tell you the stories or tales surrounding the island. During the entire trip, a guide will accompany you, who will help you explore and uncover the different areas and taverns around the island.
And this beginning of painting,
this is the red hematite painting. It is one of the few taverns around Lamanok Island. It is said to be 1,000 years old. This cave is the most enigmatic cave in the island. This is where the spirit of the island lives. This is the shaman cave.
It is made again by Mother. Kining pangalan mamaya, Joey Elijah Season. Ato naging simana doon ako bisita nga.
Here the guide explains a local practice where people ask the spirit petition, good luck and fortune. In exchange, they present gifts in a form of money, tobacco, coconut wine, or chicken. Hence, Lamanok, the Visayan word for chicken.
Unya nakita na to ni Ma'am Sir, kini healing power gikan sa namatay na tambalan. Tungod kay ang kultura o tradisyon, basta himalatyo ng tambalan, kinahanglan ang iyang kinaadman ipasa sa iyang mga anak o asawa.
Make sure to rent private vehicle kasi ang downside niya is 30 minutes na tayong naghintay dito sa waiting shed, pero wala talagang public transport dito, guys. So when you charter a tuk-tuk or a rela, their local tricycles dito, make sure that you also ask for their number so that pagtapos ng trip nyo, pwede nyo sila i-contact at saka sila na yung ride sa inyo pabalik sa poblacion area.
Let's take a side trip to the town of Corellia. Visit the famous Tarsiers of Bohol. Corellia Tarsier Sanctuary prioritize the well-being of the tarsiers. Here, they can roam freely in a protected habitat, allowing you to witness their natural behaviors and experience the true magic of the wild. What or where to eat in Bohol?
Him on Thoughts Club. Nice.
Number 1. Garden Cafe in Tagbilaran City. Garden Cafe is not just a place to eat. It's a piece of Tagbilaran's history. Stepping inside, you will feel the warmth of Boholano hospitality, blended with a touch of vintage charm. It's basically a place where time seems to slow down. The decor is one of a kind, a delightful mix of Old West nostalgia and local Boholano touches. It's like stepping into a storybook. Its menu is a testament to its legacy. Comfort food classics sits alongside local favorites.
Ito na yung in-order namin pizza, pepperoni, at saka ito yung spaghetti, and yung mango cake. This is good kasi, wow, pang American portion talaga, babe, di ba?
Maganda rin dito kasi besides being a museum for cowboys in the US and a restaurant, but they also help the community by help the deaf and the mute community. Some of their kitchen staff here are deaf and mute. It's really great because they support livelihood, something like that.
Number 2, Moadto Strip.
Where to eat here in Bohol? You can go to Panglao. Simply go head over to Moadto Strip. It's one of the newest mall here in Bohol.
This vibrant strip mall offers a variety of dining options, from seafood to local dishes, from sweet treats to coffee. There is always something for everyone. And the best part of this strip mall is it's located just in front of the beach. Don't miss to try the Boholano version of the chicken inato. Payag's chicken inato are grilled to perfection, perfectly roasted and juicy. And of course, plus factor, the super cozy and rustic ambience of the restaurant. While in Anda, be sure to find this hidden gem, Anda Food Park. This place by the beach is packed with a variety of food stalls, offering everything from Filipino street food to international favorites. Whatever you're craving, it's all right here.
Where to eat in Anda? Head over here. Meron tayong klase-klaseng mga establishments. Alright guys, so where to eat in Anda? Meron na tayong fries na in-order natin doon sa isang restaurant. Meron din tayong buttered shrimp at saka iced tea, which we ordered in another restaurant. Tapos ngayon, naghihintay lang tayo sa barbecue natin. Alright, ito na yung barbecue natin sa Tatams. Tatams Grill. So, kompleto ng dinner natin, guys. Ito na yung barbecue, shrimp, fries.
Number 5, experience serenity at the coast of Taloto.
Anong masasabi mo, Chloe?
Mas.
Nandito po tayo ngayon sa Baybay sa Taloto. Where to eat here in Tagbilaran or in Bohol. One of the great thing sa restaurant is the aesthetics. At saka may playground ka pa sa gitna.
The restaurant is an excellent spot for both locals and tourists looking to savor good food while enjoying the scenic beauty of the coastal landscape.
Nandito po tayo ngayon sa The Mist, which is located here in Tawala, Panglao. So makikita niyo dito, guys, napaka-winner talaga ang interior design sa place. Every table has its own design. At pakang kumakain ka sa isang tropical na location na restaurant. Interior design pa lang, winner na. So Tingnan natin ang klase-klase nilang mga putahe. So guys, tingin yung design ng food. Ito yung... At saka ito yung si... At saka ito yung rice.
Head to Bohol Bee Farm for pasalubong.
This is how traditional weaving looks like.
This eco-friendly farm offers a unique experience. One can enjoy the serene surroundings, delicious homemade ice cream, and explore the vibrant craft created by local artisans.
For pasalubong needs, head to Bohol Bee Farm, located here at Panglao. Pasalubong must try na to diri is ato ang pure honey, which is available here in Bohol Bee Farm. Napuntay baligya diri nga bag o usa sa pang kuyawan ako diri no kay ilahang asin tibuok, kalamay hati o bisa unsa pang uban.
The best thing that you can do here in Bohol Bee Farm here is to grab ice cream.
Hindi ko pwede ituro guys, but ito yung balete tree or ito yung kahoy kung saan may nawawalang mansyon, at saka may white lady.
Thanks for watching.